Our desire in doing the play was to create Picasso's world internally and externally. And part of our idea in doing the play and working with design and projecting images and the music that we're using is to be able to see Picasso in the course of an evening from many different angles.
I've always admired Picasso as an artist, as a human being, and I'm able to fully express myself in this play as an artist.
I wanted to have a world that enabled Picasso's life in all its different facets to be able to be shown to the audience. And I think what's really great about the way our designers have created the play is it's not just a play that you watch. I think it's really an experience.
Truth. Painting is the nearest we can get to the truth. It's a strange trade, a strange destiny, no? Putting paint on canvas, slaving, persisting, torturing oneself day and night. Why? What forces us to do it?
And the main challenge of this play was creating the art that reminded people of Picasso. And they would think, oh, that's a Picasso, but not really. It was created by me. So that was really actually kind of thrilling and kind of challenging as an actor to create pieces that look like Picasso, that feel like Picasso, but they're not the actual Picassos. Because, you know, there's only one Picasso. There can only be one Picasso.
People do not realize what they have when they own a Picasso. Each picture is a vial with my blood. That is what has gone into it.
It's kind of a thrill to paint and draw in front of an audience because you really don't know what's going to come out, even though you have an idea. So you just never know. It's live theater. It's the fullest expression that I've ever done as an artist on stage, where I was able to paint and act at the same time. It's really thrilling and it's very scary at the same time. Picasso is genius. Picasso is the ultimate artist to me. For him, life is art and art is life. A true artist should always be working, always thinking about the next thing.
Are you someone that hates the work you do? Huh? You work and work so that you can have pleasure in your spare time? Never permit a dichotomy to rule your life. I remember when I lived in Vauvenargues, a woman was strolling along and spotted me sketching at a sidewalk cafe. The presumptuous woman asked me if I could draw her and charge accordingly. I obliged. In just minutes, I drew her. There it was, an original Picasso. What do I owe you, she says. 5,000 francs. Oh, but it only took you 3 minutes. No, I said, it took me all my life.